I was just going to tell you, if anybody's ever speaking at the podium, get them too. Yeah.
Actually, could you take a picture of the thing and send it to me? The pamphlet.
Good evening. I think I'm on. Can you hear me? I may just have to put this right up close. There we go. Thank you for being with us this evening. We want to get our program started. We're excited that you're here with us tonight. We have some excellent music prepared for you this evening. We have a lot of awards to hand out because we have some awesome and talented young people seated before you tonight. We're going to start our program tonight with our clarinet quartet that you seated over here beside me this evening. This ensemble is made up of Camille Arbogast, Caitlin Burke, Raina Jones, and Peyton Ricks. These young ladies received a gold rating at the District Solo and Ensemble Contest, which qualified them for the state competition. And at the state competition, they not only received a gold rating, but also a perfect score. Tonight, they're going to be playing for you their competition piece entitled Bagatelle. Please enjoy. In addition to the clarinet quartet that you just heard, we had many other ensembles and soloists compete at the district, this year's district and state solo and ensemble contests. In fact, we earned 32 gold and one silver medal at the district competition this year. We'd like to recognize those students, so if you competed this year in the district solo and ensemble contest, would you please stand and be recognized at this time? Those students who earned a gold at the district competition and also at the group one level, then qualified for state. We had 9 students who made it to the state competition this year, and we brought home 8 gold medals and 1 silver medal. We'd like to recognize those students at this time. So if you competed at the state solo and ensemble contest this year, would you please stand and be recognized? Oh, district teacher. Thank you, teacher. Okay, now, moving on, a favorite part of our Pops and Awards concert every year is our annual slideshow. Mrs. Walker has once again put together our year in review in picture and video form. We'd like to go ahead and play that for you at this time. Please enjoy.
Rocket up into the sky, not gonna stop. Invincible! for that one yet, so hold that thought. Okay, so we would like to recognize our underclassmen for their hard work and dedication this year. And we're going to begin with our freshmen. They're receiving their numerals for their letter jackets. And when I call your name, freshmen, will you please stand and be recognized? Hold your applause, if you would, please, until all the freshmen names are read. And hopefully I don't leave anybody out. So Aaron Ayers, Grace Collins, Michaela Cook, Paul Dash, Samuel Gonzalez-Correa, Drew Hawk, Sophie Joseph, Michael Kassane, Aiden McMurray, Jalen Newman, Quentin Pearson, Casey Revis, Riley Riggs, Noah Schaefer, Stormy Shanefelt, Ryan Shinholt, Garrett Spencer, Matt Stanley, Hayden Sutton, Reese Teagle, and James Wendell. Would you give these freshmen applause, please? And our next group we'd like to recognize is our sophomores. This year, the sophomores will be receiving their Varsity M for their letter jacket. And all of these students, their awards were laying on their seats, so they're receiving those this evening. The sophomores, when I call your name, would you please stand and be recognized? And again, if you hold your applause until I read all of the names. Our first sophomore is Ian Davis, Kira Dennis, Brooklyn Dickey, Jasmine Drake, Kaylin Green, Grayson Harris-Headley, Adrian Jeter, Raina Jones, Bryce Lane, Haley Miller, Cora Perandi, Allison Payne, Chloe Pence, Josh Price, Braden Pomeroy, Emily Reno, Ethan Roberts, Micah Silty, Alyssa Terry, and Elliot Williams. Would you give our sophomores an applause, please? And then our third group we'd like to recognize are our juniors. They're going to be receiving a bar for their letter jacket. And then juniors, again, as I call your name, if you would stand and be recognized and just hold your applause again until we're finished with those names. For our juniors, Camille Arbogast, Jocelyn Buck, Caitlin Burke, Taylor Dickey, Daniela Joseph, Peyton McCoy, Wesley Shinholt, Nicholas Soltz, Audrey Spencer, Jackson Tarpin, Pierce Ward, and Caden Yackel. Would you give them an applause, please?
Next, we'd like to recognize a group of students who were selected to this year's Grant County Honor Band. The members of this Honor Band represent the top 100 band students from the five high schools in Grant County. This year, Mississinewa had 20 students selected for the Honor Band. Students, please please stand when I call your name and remain standing. And audience, please hold your applause until the last student's name is read. Jocelyn Buck, Caitlin Burke, Brooklyn Dickey, Taylor Dickey, Samuel Gonzalez-Correa, Drew Hawk, Adrian Jeter, Raina Jones, Daniela Joseph, Michael Kassane, Haley Miller, Josh Price, Peyton Ricks, Ethan Roberts, Audrey Spencer, Garrett Spencer, Max Stanley, Elliot Williams, James Wendell, and Caden Yankel. Would you please give these young people a round of applause? Also this year, we had a large group of students selected to this year's All-District Honor Band. The members of this band represent the top 80 students from high schools across the entire North Central Indiana region. This year, Mississinewa had 15 students selected for the Honor Band. Students, please stand when I call your name and remain standing. Audience, please hold your applause till the last name is read. Camille Arbogast, Caitlin Burke, Micah Crisp, Ian Davis, Brooklyn Dickey, Samuel Gonzalez, Adrian Jeter, Daniela Joseph, Kylie McMahon, Peyton Ricks, Ethan Roberts, Abigail Robinson, Ethan Sample, Wesley Shinholt, Nicholas Soltz, and Audrey Spencer. Please give them a big round of applause. And finally, one of the most prestigious awards a high school musician can earn is to be selected for the All-State Honor Band. Only 100 musicians from the entire state of Indiana are chosen for this honor each year. And in some cases, depending on the instrument they play, there may be as few as 2 possible positions for that specific instrument for the entire state. Mississinewa was extremely fortunate this year to have 2 students selected for the Honor Band. Those students are Camille Arbogast and Caitlin Burke. Please stand and be recognized. Next, we'd like to get back to some music with our jazz band. These guys have been rehearsing once a week after school since March. Tonight, they're going to be performing 2 selections for you. The first, Coral Reef, which is a great swing chart, and second, a piece called Backroads, which is a very cool, slow, and bluesy rock tune. I think you'll like them both. Please enjoy the Mississinewa Jazz Band.
Thank you.
Okay, next we would like to hand out our year-end awards. We're going to start with our Outstanding Freshman Award. The Outstanding Freshman Award is given to a freshman band member each year who has shown exceptional talent and ability. This award also recognizes a student who has quickly shown leadership ability and has set a good example for others to follow. The student who we've chosen for the award this year has shown exceptional playing ability as a freshman. He was a part of the All-District Honor Band and also the Grant County Honor Band. He took a solo to contest at the Group 1 level, received the gold rating, and went to state as a freshman, and also received the gold rating. Honestly, he's come to the high school playing like a rock star already. We always enjoy his humor. We look forward to 3 more years of this amazing young man. We would like to present tonight's Outstanding Freshman Award to Samuel Gonzalez Correa. Next is our Most Improved Band Member Award. The Most Improved Band Member Award goes to a band member from any class, freshman, sophomore, junior, or senior. This student has shown a commitment and desire to do what they can do to help the band program at Mississinewa to grow and improve. Efforts include individual preparedness, punctuality, attendance, attitude, and extra effort. The student we've chosen for this award this year has stepped up to lead in their section in a big way this year, not only in his excellent playing ability, but also just in his overall helpfulness at any turn in the road this year. He was a part of the All-District Honor Band. He was also selected for the Grant County Honor Band. He's a joy to have in band. We look forward to having another awesome year to him. And I've just got to say that it's when we hand out this award, the Most Improved Band Member Award, we're used to seeing growth. We have these guys from sixth grade all the way through 12th grade in a lot of cases. But it's rare, except for maybe at the sixth grade level where we see huge strides in improvement, it's rare once they get to the high school level to see huge leaps in improvement. And it's been fun to watch this happen right before our eyes this year. I'd like to take credit for it, but I think it was all him. So whatever you're doing, Wes, keep doing it, and I would love to watch it and take credit for it some more. So Wes Shinholt, come on up. Most Improved Band Member. Next is our Brian D. Bryant Music Award. The Brian D. Bryant Award goes to a senior band and choir member. The award was established in 1976, the year of Brian's untimely death, to honor his memory. Brian was a member of both the band and choir at Mississinewa. He is remembered for his dependability, loyalty, and all-around outstanding character. This award is selected by Mr. Bear, Mrs. Walker, and also Mrs. Walters, our choir director. This student was unable to fit band in his schedule this year, but he worked hard to be able to be at all of our events and still continue to be a valuable member of our group. He participated in the All-District Honor Band as well as Jazz Band. He's an outstanding singer. He participated in musicals as well as the regular choir class. He went to solo and ensemble in choir and received a gold rating. He was selected for the Indiana All-State Jazz Choir. He exemplifies outstanding character and loyalty, all things that make up this award. He's just a joy to have in our music program. We would like to give this year's Brian D. Wright Award to Micah Crisp.
Our next award is a new award that we are doing for this year. And I would like to introduce a couple who have asked to do this award and asked to also present it. This is a young man that we had in our band several years ago, who was just a wonderful, wonderful young man. And we miss him tremendously. Well, we really would like his parents to come up and share a little bit about him. This is our Jacob David Cottrell Award. And Luz Maria and Robin, would you come up? Or Luz Maria's coming. So I'm going to turn the microphone over to Luz Maria and let her share just a little bit, and then share who these awards went to.
I'm just going to read what I wrote. Uniqueness, the quality of being, you got to excuse me, for some reason, I woke up with laryngitis today. I'm not sick, so. Uniqueness, the quality of being particularly remarkable, special, or unusual that bring out creativity in a person. The Jacob David Cottrell Memorial Fund was created to honor his legacy. He loved God, all people, and the love of music. In his words, helped him through the darkest times he faced. He was a Mississinewa High School and Indiana Wesleyan University graduate. All his life, he always strived to work hard, achieve his goals. In high school, he was third in his class, played 3 sports for 4 years, and did band for 8. He did it in 5th grade. He played piano, trumpet, drumline, and before he passed, he was learning to play the guitar. While in college, he became ill and was diagnosed with Ehlers-Danlos syndrome type 4, a very rare disorder. Not only a rare disorder, but in 2013, he was the 2nd person in the world, the 1st in the USA, to be diagnosed with an additional breakage in the gene. He started Indiana Wesleyan to become a doctor. Because of illness, he changed to nursing and was getting ready to start clinicals when he suffered a massive stroke. But still attending college, he changed his major to addictions counseling, graduating only a half semester behind. He sang in a Christian rap band, made and produced beats. He endured 13 surgeries while in college, and he survived 17 in his life. He gave back to his community as a child, from a child to adulthood. When he was told he could not work because of his condition, he didn't let that stop him. He volunteered at several schools in campus life, helping students achieve their goals. He was active in his church and ran sound and music. It's been a terrible long year without our son. But we still have people telling us how he changed and would counsel them at any time of day or night. This scholarship was started with his own money, but it is a seed that we hope in Christ will grow. It may not be a significant amount, but Jacob David Cottrell lives on. This year, the first scholarship to be awarded is being given in his honor and is going to 2 students, because we couldn't, both students amplified a lot of our son. Ethan Sample is one, and Todd Burness. Burness is the other. Congratulations.
The scholarship awards at senior honor night. So we just wanted to recognize them also this evening, since this was a band award, and it was just something that was very important to us to include this evening. So we really want to congratulate these gentlemen on this award. Our next award is our Outstanding Musician Award. This award is given annually to a band member from any class who demonstrates superior skill, exceptional character, and overall outstanding achievement on his or her own musical instrument. We have an amazing set of musicians in our band, and you can already tell that tonight, even just only hearing our quartet and then the jazz band. And so this is a tough award to just choose one person. It's really a tough thing, and we ponder this quite a bit. However, this particular student has set herself apart year after year by being the very best that she can be. She's participated in all district band, Grant County Honor Band, all state band. She took a Group 1 solo to contest and received a gold rating at state, as well as performed in a Group 1 ensemble, and they went to state earning a gold. In fact, she has taken a Group 1 solo all the years of her high school career and received the gold every single time. And that's amazing for a student to do that. It's exceptional for someone to do that. She's received this award 2 years in a row, and this makes it her third year in a row. She's easy to work with, and she's one of the hardest workers that I know. We'd like to give our Outstanding Musician Award to Caitlin Burke. Award. This award is to recognize distinguished high school band members for their musical achievements and their leadership as a high school scholar. Recipients of the award should be exemplary young citizens and role models for the other students. This award displays great honor from the United States Marine Corps. Semper Fidelis means always faithful. The student that receives this award has given many hours of dedication to the music program. This is also going to be presented at Senior Honor Night as well, but we always like to honor the student. There'll be no certificate or even plaque this evening, but they'll receive something the night of Senior Honor Night. But we would like to recognize the student because it's important to us. She's been an outstanding member of the band program. She's participated in the All-District Honor Band, as well as solo and ensemble for the last 4 years. She's very faithful to the band program. She's a role model. She's a hard worker for the rest of her section. She strives to be the best that she can be in what she does. This award will be presented, as I mentioned, on Senior Honor Night, but we'd like to recognize this student, which is Abigail Robinson. John Philip Sousa Award goes to a senior that was voted on by each of the band members. This is the only award that we ask the students to vote and help us do that. It began in 1954 because John Philip Sousa's dedication to music. It's a prestigious award. It's nationally recognized across the country. One high school band member is chosen from many schools. The student who we've chosen this evening and the students have chosen this evening is an exemplary band member. She's one that's a quiet leader. She leads by an example. She always has her partner. She always helps other people in her section to be the best that they can be. She's participated in solo and ensemble. They received a gold rating on a mallet quartet. You've already probably figured out who this is. She's just an all-around hard worker. And the vote from the students just tells you how highly she's respected in the band program. And we'd like to give the John Philip Sousa Award to Elena Parami. Our next award here is our Crimson Pride Director's Award. The Director's Award goes to a junior or senior band member. And the student chosen for this honor is one who displays superior musicianship, leadership, dependability, loyalty, and cooperation. The student we've chosen tonight is, again, one of those quiet leaders. Now, that doesn't mean just because you're quiet you can get an award. And that doesn't mean because you're loud that you can't get an award. But we just happen to have a couple of students this evening that just have that quiet leadership, and they do that very well in their section. She's a joy to have in band. She's just easy to work with, and she works hard. She's like a sponge. She just works and works to try to do the very best that she can and make herself better all the time. She's participated in all district honor band, Grant County honor band, as well as solo and ensemble. She took a solo to district contest, and this young lady just worked very, very hard and wasn't sure. Sometimes she'd make faces at me and she'd be like, I don't think I can do this. And she did this, and she did. And she went to contests, and she got a gold, and she played amazing. She also was in the quartet that you saw this evening that got a perfect score. And she worked very hard in that quartet. She's an amazing young lady, and we're going to miss having her next year. And we'd like to give our Director's Award to Peyton Ricks.
Okay, we'd like to play some more music for you. Our next two selections are from this year's ISMA District Organizational Contest. Our concert band not only received the gold rating contest this year, but earned ISMA's prestigious Gold with Distinction because of their outstanding performance. Less than 20% of Indiana bands earn this award annually. Takes a lot of hard work, a lot of dedication, a lot of commitment for these students to dedicate themselves to that level of rehearsal, let's call it focus, to take their music to that level. Please help me congratulate these students for this excellent achievement. Tonight they'll be performing their two contest pieces entitled Darkman's March. It's their first one, and the second one, Cut to the Chase. Please enjoy.
Thank you.
have a few papers this evening, but we found one. All right, next we would like to honor our seniors. We'd like to recognize our seniors this evening by having them come to the front as we call their name. These students will be receiving a bar for their letter jacket, as well as their senior blanket, in recognizing their dedication to the high school band for the past 4 years. We asked the students also to tell us their future plans and their most memorable moment in band, which is always fun. So we'll start this evening by asking Todd Briggs to come on up to the front. Todd. Okay, so Todd plans to attend Indiana Wesleyan University to major in social studies education. As far as his most memorable moment in band, and I have not previewed these, so look out. His most memorable moment in band was the playground day last year, which was our reward for a great contest performance. Awesome. How about a round of applause for Todd? Next up is Micah Crisp. Micah, come on down. Micah plans to attend Indiana Wesleyan University and major in music composition. Awesome. As far as his most memorable moment in band, it was marching in the Bluffton Street Fair Parade. Let's hear it from Micah Crisp. Next up, Kylie McMahon. Kylie plans to study social work at IUPUI, and her most memorable moment in band was all of marching band, especially the parades. Let's hear it for Kylie. Elena Barandi. Are to attend Indiana Wesleyan University and study music education. Her most memorable moment in band was when Ethan Miller hid his leopard geckos in the percussion room during a concert. I have not heard about this one. Are they still there? To tell me about that one later. All right, let's hear it for Elena Brandy.
Our next senior is Peyton Riggs. Come on down, Peyton. And Peyton Riggs' future plans. I haven't decided yet because I'm terrible at making decisions. I would be a professional procrastinator if I could be. Those are good plans. All right. And then, what's your most memorable moment in band? Probably when my ensemble got a perfect score contest, even after the group before us played the exact same song as we did. So let's give it for. And our next senior is Caitlin Ramey. And Caitlin Ramey's future plans are to attend IUK for paramedics and social work. And then her most memorable moment is having to ask little Micah to help with any bass drum malfunctions I had for the last 2 years. Little Micah. All right, give a hand for Caitlin Ramey. Our next senior is Abigail Robinson. Abigail's future plans are to attend Indiana Wesleyan University with a major in biology. And her most memorable moment is, I'm looking really quick, practicing for solo ensemble with Jocelyn and Daniela, arguing like an old married couple. All right, give a hand for Abigail Robinson. And then our last senior, Ethan Sample. To go to Purdue University and study electrical engineering. I want to work for NASA. And then his most memorable moment, watching Josh Terrell flail his arms like a crazy person mimicking a roller coaster at the football games.
Walker came up to me and started talking with me. She welcomed me to the school and made sure I knew she was there for me. Fast forward several months, and she proved how much she would be there for me and for all of us. I think all the seniors can agree that our freshman year was a rough one. We had just lost Ms. Nielsen and had a new teacher. I won't go much into that, but I think we all know. Sophomore year, Mr. Barry came back to our school and saved the day, or years, I should say. I know these silly little things probably don't mean much to everyone else, but it shaped who I am today. I'm just one person, and both of these teachers have helped me phenomenally. Imagine all the other people that they have helped, not just in the last year or a few years, but every year they have taught. To show our appreciation, the seniors have come up with a little gift. It may not look too special, but let me give some context. So Peyton here has a list of rules that we have, just so that the upcoming freshmen can know exactly what to expect, always. And then we have a bouquet of flowers and Hershey's. And then the next gift that we have was really Todd's idea to explain during pep band, sometimes it's a little too dark or a little too loud and you can't really tell what song is up next. Todd had the idea to get a whiteboard so the next year's pep season will be easier to prepare for what song comes next. I would just like to recognize all that Ms. Walker and Mr. Bear have done for us, and on behalf of all the seniors, thank you.
I can't decide if we need to read these band room rules or not. Students should be ready to play the first downbeat. If you can't do this, then I suggest you go to drama. These are good rules, I like them.
Seniors, that was awesome. You guys surprised us. We got to get through the rest of this, though, so a couple big swallows here, and let's keep going. But a big thank you, guys. For the last part of our program tonight, we'd like to play our two pop tunes for you. These are always favorites for us. Fun tunes, popular tunes that we know and hopefully you guys are familiar with and that the kids know and love. The first is the theme song from the most recent James Bond movie released in 2021 titled No Time to Die. It was written and recorded by Billie Eilish and her brother Phineas. They were able to not only create a beautiful theme, but also to capture those hints of signature James Bond sounds and style throughout. I think you'll enjoy this next piece. For this one, we want to invite our student teacher, Mr. McNulty, to the podium to conduct. We've been lucky to have Mr. McNulty with us this semester. He officially graduated from Ball State on Saturday, but he's been kind enough to stay on with us through our final concert of the year, which is next Tuesday with our middle school. We also appreciate some of the special percussion parts, which he wrote specifically for this piece tonight, and you'll be able to hear those if you listen for those. So we really appreciate all of the work, the hard work, the dedication that he's given to our students and to our program. And we want to congratulate him on the end of his semester and his student teaching and the beginning of his future as a music educator, and invite him to the podium at this time for No Time to Die.
Thank you.
Before we play our last piece tonight, I don't want this evening to get away from us without saying some special thank yous. I want to thank our administration for their continued support. Without them, none of this would be possible. I want to thank Tribe TV for live streaming for us tonight, for the people who couldn't be here, so that they could be enjoying our performance. You can also go to their website to watch the recording of this if you'd like to see it again. I want to thank our students. Without them, also, none of this would be possible. Their hard work, their dedication is what keeps us coming back. I also want to thank them for helping us to keep it fun. I want to thank those students who were here after school, who stayed to help set up, and those who have volunteered to stay after to tear down. I want to thank parents in the audience this evening. We appreciate you giving us your trust, believing in what we're trying to accomplish here, teaching music education, using this to teach important life skills and build character within these young people. It truly is a joy doing what we do. We appreciate your support, and without it, without the encouragement that you give your children, we wouldn't be able to do what we do. I want to thank Mrs. Walker for putting up with me every day. Don't need to say any more about that. My family who's here tonight, you guys. Thank you guys. You guys are always there for me. I want to thank a special guest who's here. First time in 25 years of doing this that I've been able to have him here. But my high school band director is here this evening, Mr. Gruner. Hey, Greg. For me, it's a real full circle moment to be able to be standing in the place where he was always standing, to be able to be leading students when he was always the one leading me, to be able to be telling students to be quiet when he was always telling me to be quiet. I still don't know what Mutt and Jeff was. You always called me Mutt and Jeff and my friend. I'll figure it out someday. Okay, you can explain. It was really neat that he was able to take a kid who was way more interested in sports, show me that I had talent in music that I didn't know that I had. Sorry, let me try to keep going here. Anyway, somehow he showed me that I had some talent in music. He was there encouraging me, kicking me in the butt when I needed it. And eventually, he's the reason why I came to Ball State from Missouri. And so, sorry for getting emotional. I had a few more things to say, but I think it's going to be hard. It all boils down to thank you. He really was the one who was able to make music fun. He never let me settle for less than my best. And that's what I try to do with these guys. So Greg, it's taken me 35 years, but thank you. And thank you for being here tonight. You want to introduce Candy to Morgan?
Well, on a little lighter moment, sorry. And so we are going to play our last and final piece for you, The Mandalorian. And we've been waiting for 2 years to do this piece, and we finally got to do it this year. So I'm very excited. So we have a mascot. And if you know anything about the movie The Mandalorian, the series The Mandalorian, I watch it a lot, can you tell? Anyway, my husband got me this, and this is Grogu. This is not Baby Yoda. So just to clarify, this is Grogu. So this is our mascot while we are playing The Mandalorian. Who wants to hold it? Jocelyn's got it, all right. All right, so our final piece for you tonight, The Mandalorian. And we thank you so much for coming out this evening. I know sometimes it gets a little long for us at these programs, but we think it's very important to honor our students, and because they deserve it. And we really feel like it's important to take some time for them, to give them the awards and to honor them. So we thank you for coming and putting up a little longer in your seats. I know, and it's hard to listen when your seat gets a little tired. So thank you for doing that. And have a safe trip home. Thank you also to our administration for being very supportive of our music program, because without you, we would not be able to do this. We appreciate you as well. So, The Mandalorian.